So Lester is really welcoming the grant from the AMA to Kingsley General and not you?
That's about it.
Well, no one ever accused Lester for doing anything for the right motive. I mean, there's no reason to begin now, right? Hey, while that may take some of the joy away, the offer's still real. And the satisfaction you're going to have being back at Kingsley General's real, too. Hey, I mean, like, I think diagnostic medicine is a wonderful idea.
You do.
Isn't it a wonderful idea?
Come over here, Lori. I want to talk to you.
Don't stop pacing now, Samir. The people in the room below us just got used to the noise.
With all respect, Your Highness, let us admit we were misinformed and go home. Your father is over-anxious. This Dave Phillips is not in Kingsley.
He is, and we will wait until he is found. I will answer. Yes.
Meddings here.
What have you found?
A lot of dead ends. It seems this Dave Phillips has gone to great lengths to protect his privacy.
You are not telling me what I wish to hear.
I am not telling you what I wish to hear. I think my next best bet would be to check the hospitals, to see if he is associated with any of them. If that doesn't pan out...
If that doesn't pan out, then you will come up with an alternate plan.
You know, Your Highness, you really ought to take a course in employer-employee relations.
The generous salary you are paid more than compensates for any lack of diplomacy on my part. Of course, if you would like a change in our relationship, I will be more than happy to renegotiate.
Some other time, perhaps.
You will call me in an hour with whatever you do or don't turn up.
I will call you with every... Oh, the charm of a cobra. About ready to strike.
So we sit here and wait.
He said can have patience, can have anything, Samir.
Patience is only despair disguised as a virtue. I am a man of action. I want to do something.
Have patience, Samir. You will wait until you are given an order. This is not our country, and we will not move openly.
It is not Felix Medding's country, either.
He is less conspicuous. You will have your chance, Samir.
America. Everywhere I look, I see waste and aimlessness.
Which will make our mission here that much easier to fulfill.
Yes.
Still, there is much to admire here, too.
This attraction of yours to other cultures disturbs me. Doria civilization is ancient. It has served her well for centuries. The modern world would do well to learn from it, and not the other way around.
Doria civilization has served her so well that she is a fifth-rate power on a continent where she should be a leader.
And she will assume her leadership role in time, but by following our own example and not those of others.
You forget, Samir, that as future leader of our people, I will set Dorian policy.
I do not forget that, Your Highness. I simply point out that it is not necessarily a disadvantage not to be an American in the age of Americans.
I do not wish to be American, Russian, or English. But to be Dorian in the 21st century, it is necessary to be a bit of each of these, and any other country we wish to deal with as well. My people will see the wisdom of that. All of my people.
As attractive as the offer is, I really don't want to go back to Kingsley General.
Okay. Why?
I couldn't take the routine.
Oh, I see. As opposed to the clinic, which isn't routine, with which you've been totally satisfied lately.
I haven't said anything about being unhappy down there.
No. Just every time you walk in here, you say it.
Lori, I've not said one
word
to you.
Wait a minute. Do you know exactly what I mean, Ben? Now, I cannot remember the last kind thing you said about a patient you've had down at the clinic. I cannot remember when you've come in with a funny little story. Or the last time you were happy. I mean really happy for making the decision you made to help those people.
Oh, I see. Uh-huh. Is that what we're after? Some sort of emotional Shangri-La where I come floating in after work?
All I am after is a little honesty from you. Now, I'm not saying that your feelings aren't valid. I'm saying I know the clinic can be frustrating.
This is not about the clinic.
That's right. That's right. This is about your dissatisfaction with medicine in general.
Maybe I have a right to be dissatisfied.
Maybe you do. But that doesn't mean that you can blow this dissatisfaction all out of proportion. Look, I know that you've been through a rough time, Ben, but don't go making hasty decisions just on what you're feeling right now. I mean, you probably feel differently in a couple of weeks.
And if I don't?
You will.
And if I don't?
So if that happens, then we'll just sit down and we'll talk over what your next move will be.
Are we putting some kind of time frame on all this? Or will we both just know when the magic moment arrives?
I don't know why you're being this way. I am on your side. Look, I'm not your punching bag. But I'm there. I'm there for whatever you're going through.
I know. I just wish I knew what it was.
Dave Phillips. Dr. Dave Phillips. I thought he was gynecologist, but maybe he might
excuse me. Why do you want to see Dr. Phillips?
Do you know him? Is he here?
I'll take care of this, Donna.
Oh, thank you, Mrs. Davidson.
You know Dave Phillips?
Yes, but may I ask who you are, please?
Oh, excuse me, how rude of me. Ivan Koloff.
I'm Terry Davidson, director of nursing here.
And a friend of Dave Phillips?
Yes.
Well, so am I, or at least I was. I haven't seen him for many years. I've been trying to locate him again, but he seems to have vanished.
Well, your search is over.
I can't tell you how happy it makes me to hear you say that. Is he here in the hospital?
Well, his practice is in the Chesterfield section of the city at a free clinic.
Could you give me directions?
Yes, of course I can. But I'll tell you what, why don't I just give him a call and he can give you the directions himself?
No, I'd rather surprise him.
I understand.
I can't tell you how difficult it has been to locate him again. I mean, unlisted telephone number, former practice, abandoned. If you ask me, I think he tried to leave town.
Well, you're close. He did leave a few years ago. But since he's come back, well, I'll let him fill you in on all the details.
Still a man of mystery after all these years.
Is that how you look at him?
Oh, I could tell you some stories. But I think I'll take your advice and let him fill me in. Huh? Now, about those directions.
Oh, right. Let me see.
The spark is still there. I'm telling you, Pete, don't deny it.
Gary, will you get out of here, please?
Listen, I ran into Courtney over at the bookstore the other day, and your name came up in a conversation dealing with something or other. But anyway, she was all ears. She wanted to know how you were doing, if you picked a project for psych, if you turned in your
lab. Gary, Courtney and I are through. You just misunderstood her interest.
I did not misunderstand the interest. The story is true.
Well, the point is it's immaterial because I'm just not interested anymore.
And if you believe that, ladies and gentlemen, I've got some oceanfront property in Kansas to sell you.
Please, see these notes here?
Yeah.
See these notes? You see the clock on the wall? By the time the big hand gets around again, I have to have these notes committed to memory. And if I don't, I'm gonna fail this exam. That's your cue to go bother somebody else, please.
Sorry you don't believe me.
He's in some kind of mood today, huh?
Ever since him and Courtney split up. Wish it was something I could do about it.
Yeah, I'll bet. $1.23?
No, I'm serious. I just want to know if there's anything I can do to help. There's gotta be.
Well, if you feel like playing Cupid, Juliet just arrived.
What?
Ask me, she's a fool to let Davidson take a walk. He's a dog.
Yeah. Yeah, why don't you tell him that? Like you did the other day.
Nurse, what time is it?
It's exactly 3 minutes later than it was last time you asked.
I got people to see, you know.
So do we, honey.
Could have fooled me.
I don't think this is what Florence Nightingale had in mind when she started this profession.
Good morning.
Hello. What can we do for you?
It's my ear. It's been pounding all morning and hurts very bad. I wonder if I could have it looked at.
Yes, sir, but...
Excellent.
Well, hold on just a minute. Did you know this is a free clinic?
Oh, is it really? That's wonderful. I'm rather short on cash lately.
Name?
Koloff. Ivan Koloff. Koloff, two L's and two F's.
Two L's and two F's and no sense of propriety. The dude comes in here wearing a $30 necktie and wants us to treat him for free.
Well, ours is not to reason why.
It will be soon as I talk to Dr. Martin and Dr. Phillips.
Hello?
Say what?
Hello.
You talk funny.
I beg your pardon?
You're one of them foreigners, aren't you?
I don't understand.
You come from another country.
Oh, yes, that's right.
Montana.
What about it?
That's where you're from.
Yes, that's right.
Do yourself a favor and stay away from the blonde.
Oh?
She's one cold broad. Oh. Parts her hair with an axe every morning.
What about Dr. Phillips?
What about him?
Well, what's he like?
Don't trust him.
Oh, really? Why not?
He can't figure out what's wrong with me.
Well, do you know?
Of course.
Well, what is it?
I drink a little too much.
Well, maybe you should stop drinking. Then you won't come here anymore.
Why don't you mind your own business?
I read in the papers where the doctor recently inherited some kind of Bible.
He inherited that thing?
Oh, you've seen it?
I've seen it. He wanted to give it to me.
Are you sure?
Of course I am. I turned him down, of course. As old as the hills, all falling apart. Who would ever think that ratty old thing would be of value?
Oh, but it is, I assure you, madam.
I could steal one of them Gideon Bibles out of any hotel, and it would be a hardback cover. Things sure have changed when a paperback costs something like that.
Paperback? We must be talking about two different things.
I sure hope so.
Oh, Mr. Lancelot.
Ms. Redlin. Is Dr. Phillips in?
No, but we expect him to show up, dude.
Good.
Ah. What you got in there?
That's the Darsalon Bible. He wanted to see it, and I thought now would be as good a time as any.
Huh? I don't know, Gary. Last time he just...
Just do it. Listen, I guarantee you, he'll be ready to talk to you this time.
Okay. Hi. What's the matter? Can't you concentrate?
May I?
It looks as if you already have.
Tell you, it's been one day, I'll tell you. Dr. Cummings threw this real bomb at us in American Lead.
If only you would.
The Faulkner paper is due a week earlier.
Hadn't you better hurry up and get started?
You want to know what my thesis is? Faulkner and Melville, were they the same person? I mean, think about it. Nobody's ever got a picture of those two together, right? Right. Literary humor. So, how are you doing?
Busy. Very busy. As you can see, I still am.
Yeah. You know, it's a nice thing that you did for Pete there, letting him go like that. You know, I've needed a scorecard to keep up with the number of girls that he's asked out since then. Personally, I think he's as miserable as you are. Why don't you two stop pretending?
Well, I can see it was a mistake for me to come here today.
Was it? I think you came here hoping to run into Pete. Now, why don't you be honest about why? Courtney. Is everything okay?
Oh, everything looked just fine from where I sat.
Huh?
I've been hearing tales about your conquests.
Oh, yeah? What would that matter to you?
This is the book that's causing all the commotion, huh?
This is it.
Well, let's have a peek at it.
No, I'm really afraid I can't let you do that.
Why not? It's not going to disintegrate if the air hits it or something, is it?
No, of course not. It's not that kind of artifact.
Well, then let's look at it.
No, I'm really not authorized to let you do that.
Oh, quit being such a scaredy cat. Dr. Phillips is selling this thing to help support the clinic, right?
Yes, he is.
We're part of the clinic, right?
Well, yes, but...
Well, then let's have a look at what's going to help pay our salaries for the next few months. Dr. Phillips won't mind if he doesn't care what differences it make to you.
All right. Excuse me, who are these people?
Oh, it's a gang of international art thieves. They heard you were bringing the Bible over here today, so they're just waiting to steal it.
Okay, I guess a little peek wouldn't hurt.
Now you're talking.
Why is it wrapped up in that container like that?
Because that keeps it protected. Do you mind?
That's it? Well, it's real unusual.
It's magnificent.
Excuse me, who are you?
Just a lover of old books. If I'm not mistaken, it is a gun to Rothbard.
No, it's not, but that's very close. It's German, it's of the same era, but unlike the Rothbard, it's not in the Latin text, it's in the vernacular.
What in the world are the two of you talking about?
We've got a scholar in our midst.
Oh, I hardly deserve that distinction, but thank you very much anyway. Now, could I hold it in my hands?
No, I don't think that'd be wise.
Oh, I understand. I see my mistake now. If it had been a Rothbard, it would have gilding on this edge. And besides, you wouldn't be quite so careless with the treasure if it were for real. Because, I mean, a Rothbard is worth several hundred thousand.
Oh, it's a lot more costly than that.
I beg your pardon?
Well, you see, that is God's direct communication to his people. And you can't put a price tag on that, no matter how it's packaged.
Oh, I see. You're right, of course.
I think I better put this away. Thank you.
But thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to look at it. Excuse me, madame, but do you know how long it will be before the doctor arrives?
What?
Well, I wonder if I might have enough time to run down to the corner to buy a newspaper.
Oh, yeah, you got time.
Thank you.
You said goodbye to me, so why should anything I do in there make any difference to you?
Do you really need it spelled out for me?
I guess I do.
I'm trapped, Peter.
You're trapped because you allowed yourself to be trapped.
No!
You still love me. So doesn't that open up a bunch of new options for you?
I realized I was still in love with you when I said yes to Vaughn. And when I asked you to leave, nothing's changed.
Yes, it has. Now I know you love me.
And you seriously haven't all along.
Courtney. Please. Tell Vaughn that you've given it a second.
Peter, stop.
Why?
I've explained this to you. None of this changes anything. My decision still stands. And it's not because I've allowed myself to be caught. Peter, I was maneuvered into a corner by Vaughn and my father. I did everything I could to get away.
Courtney, your father and Vaughn, they don't love you. Their actions say that. Now, don't fall for these lines about
their
family.
Their love isn't the issue here. It's mine for my mother that's at the heart of this. As long as she's alive, I cannot live with any decision that would hurt her, no matter what it did to me. I'm sorry if you don't understand that.
I've seen it. I have practically touched it. The fools are keeping it in a poor people's clinic where it is completely unprotected.
Are you sure? This is not another one of your mistakes.
Samir, do not play your silly games with me, I am sure. Now get your hulking self down here and help me.
Is that Felix?
He's not only found the doctor, but the Bible also.
Where?
And a pleasant good afternoon to you again, Your Highness.
You found the Bible so quickly?
That disappoints you.
Where?
Please send your genius for overstatement in a cab down to the Chesterfield Free Clinic. You call the airport and make sure everything is taken care of there. We will be on an airplane with the Bible on our way back to Doria in a matter of hours.
Thank you.